Follow us on social media, support us on Patreon. All links in description below. Russia's defense ministry has confirmed that it's planning to send S-300 air defense systems to Syria in support of Bashar al-Assad regime. This development has resulted in very aggressive commentary from Israel and Russia. Israeli Defense Minister Avigdor Lieberman said, "One thing should be clear, if someone fires on our planes, we will destroy them." Lieberman was reported by Haaretz as saying, "What's important to us is that the weapons defense systems that the Russians transfer to Syria are not used against us. If they're used against us, we will act against them." Lieberman acknowledged that the S-300 systems were already being used in Syria, but only in defense of Russian assets and not against Israel. Russian officials cautioned against targeting the equipment. If Israel attacks them, they said, it will suffer catastrophic consequences. The S-300 is a series of highly capable, long-range, surface-to-air missile complexes first deployed in the USSR in 1979 and later modified by the Russian armed forces. Many versions of the lethal system have been derived. Experts believe that Russia is most likely to be delivering the S-300 PMU-2 variant. In this video, Defense Updates lists 5 reasons why Israel should fear Russian S-300 in Syria. Let's get started.
Number 5.
In the past, we've seen this tactic being applied successfully when in April 1986, SR-71 Blackbird outran SA-2 surface-to-air missile over Libya. But in this case, the tactic will be useless since Israel's F-35 has a top speed of only Mach 1.6, whereas F-16s have a top speed of Mach 2, and missiles deployed by S-300 have much higher speeds, some even being hypersonic. For example, 9M-96E2 missile has a speed of Mach 14.
Number 4.
The missiles deployed by S-300, like 40N6 and 9M96E1, are not only guided by the system, but also have active radar homing, ARH, capabilities. These missiles contain a radar transceiver and the electronics necessary for it to find and track its target autonomously on their own. So these missiles are guided to the target by radars of S-300 in the initial stage, but when they reach near, they can maneuver on their own. Hence, there's no lag as they're not dependent on the transmission from ground radars. This makes the missiles very agile and hard to shrug off.
Number 3.
Israel's F-16s are non-stealthy fighters, and S-300 has multiple powerful radars operating in different bands. So S-300 is not expected to have any difficulty in detecting and targeting F-16 fighters. Israel's F-35s will be trump card here as it's a fifth-generation stealthy aircraft. In December 2017, Israel declared that its first squadron of F-35s is operational. The Israeli Air Force's 140 Golden Eagle Squadron has 9 F-35I fighters. It's a complex call if Israel will be likely to deploy its newest fighter in a risky environment like this or not. But even if it decides so, the situation will not be easy. The F-35's airframe is not as stealthy as found in the F-22. Against X-band radars, it's only stealthy from front and rear. Against S-band radar, it's stealthy from narrow front aspect. Against L-band radar, limited reduction is achieved from direct front. It has much greater reliance on radar-absorbing materials. Overall, F-35 is much easier to detect when compared to F-22 Raptor. It also must be noted that wherever the weapon bays are opened, the stealth profile is greatly compromised. Apart from traditional radars, S-300 can be integrated with radars that are capable of detecting stealthy aircraft. It's not clear if Russia is deploying that kind of advanced radar in the Syrian theater.
Number 2.
Israel's Air Force F-16 and especially F-35 have highly capable electronic warfare (EW) suits that can initiate network attack and radar jamming to suppress enemy air defenses. But S-300 has many features specifically designed to overcome these countermeasures. For example, the very powerful radar is resistant to jamming due to its ability to change frequency of its signals very rapidly. S-300 also can be equipped with Topaz Kolchuga M, KRTP-91 Tamara, and 85V6 Orion Vega emitter locating systems. These components are designed to engage emitting targets without emitting from the acquisition radars, or if the acquisition radars have been jammed. So it will not be easy to disable S-300 with EW.
Number 1.
Israel has several missiles that can be used from long range. Popeye and Delilah have range of about 250 kilometers and can be launched from air as well as sea, making them versatile. But successful standoff preemptive strike against S-300 is not an easy task to accomplish. S-300 is designed to be mobile. Self-propelled wheeled all-terrain chassis carries all system components. This means the system can be in a different position at different times, making a pre-planned strike difficult. It's also a highly modular system. For example, the radar can be used independently of the missiles for command and control purposes. So just because the radar is there doesn't mean the entire system is there. These aspects make it very unpredictable and difficult to target. Even if detected, S-300 will be a very tough nut to crack. The long-range surveillance radar tracks objects over a range of 300 kilometers. The engagement radar, which is responsible for guiding the missiles towards the target, is a very capable one. It can guide up to 12 missiles simultaneously, engaging up to 6 targets at once. Each launcher vehicle carries 4 missile containers. A full battalion includes 6 launcher vehicles with a total of 24 missiles. What makes matters more complex is that both Popeye and Delilah are subsonic, and there's high probability of these being intercepted by S-300 before they can do any damage.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.